expressions in Python. So what exactly an outcome plan for this video? So after the watching this video, the audience would be able to use Lambda expressions in Python. In this hands-on session, what we'll be looking into this is we'll be more focusing on syntax, writing Lambda expression. So let us define a function. So what the function would do is given a variable, it would just increment the value of that variable by 2. So I'll name the function as increment by 2, and I'll provide a variable. So this method will always return variable plus 2. So now if I check the output of this method, and if I pass 2 value here, you can guess the output. Let me run this code now. So you can see the output of the code is 4, because I have a method which, upon passing a variable, which will be returning a variable whose value is incremented by a 2. Now this same code, what I will be doing here is, let me prepend it with a small string here. Let us execute this once again. Okay, so the function call, the value is 4. Okay, now the exact function which we wrote in form of Python function syntax, we can also write it in form of a Lambda. So generally a syntax of Lambda goes in this way. So we write a word Lambda, and usually Lambda is assigned to some variable here. Then I define an argument this Lambda expression would be taking. So these arguments here, so generally these arguments here are equivalent to function arguments. For example, here I'm passing var. So this is one argument here. So here my Lambda would also take one argument. And had this method had two arguments, like var1 and var2, I can also do the same thing here in Lambda syntax when I'm specifying the arguments. Then once I specify the arguments for this Lambda, and after putting a colon, I need to have an expression here which might involve all the arguments or some of the arguments of this Lambda, or it can be in any expression which returns a value. So for example, here I can do something, for example, args plus 2 or some kind of operation here. So instead of writing something, what we will call it as, we call it an expression. Now in Python, it is sometimes there is a lot of controversial discussion, like what exactly are expressions and what exactly are statements. So in a quick layman's word, what I can tell you is, here whenever I use the word expression, I mean a expression or a some kind of operation here which usually returns a value. So as a thumb, we can roughly in a layman word, we can just stick to this definition. Remember, it can't include some statements like if statement or some kind of Python set of Python operations which do not return a value. So given a syntax, now let us write a syntax definition by converting the method increment by 2 into Lambda. So let us do what, and we'll call it as inc by 2. This would be the name of my Lambda, is equal to, now I'm converting that into Lambda. Lambda is a standard, it's a keyword, it's not a some variable name, or it's a standard keyword. And here I'm passing a argument var, and what will happen this var? So it is always var plus 2. So this is the Lambda inc by 2. So now if I want to call that, I'll take the exact method here, and instead of function call, what we'll do now, we'll call it by Lambda here. Here, and instead of increment by 2, now what I'll do is, I'll do it called as inc by 2. So now if I execute this, you can see that it has also executed Lambda call 4. Now the very best use of Lambda is when we want to use custom sorting. So let us call, let's have a list, and we'll call them as sample numbers. and I'll put some values here for 5 and 0 minus 3 and okay, and what I want is I want to sort this array, and we all know that to sort an array we do have something list dot sort, but we don't use it because it does a in place sorting. We want a sorting without modifying the original. We always use sorted. So to the sorted we'll provide a sample numbers. Now if I check the output of this, you can see that it's sorted. Now here my requirement, now you can just observe the output. The output is ordered, it's sorted in ascending order, where like lower values to higher. What if I want to override the default sorting order by sorted method, and I want this sorting to happen from higher value to lower? So in short, I want a descending ordered sort. So what should I do? In that case, what we do is we write the lambda here. So same call goes here. And the second argument is the key, which is actually a function. We are supposed to give a function here. So we have two options. Either you write a function and provide the function, or you mention a lambda here. So what I'll do is I'll say lambda, so a variable. And what I want here is, so since I want to reverse it, the quick way to calculate the max and give the subtraction of that. So what I'll do is I'll call max. So max gives me the maximum of number in a list. So I have a list of sample numbers, and I'll say minus var. So this would effectively ensure that I get a keys in descending order. Okay, lambda max minus var. Let me put this in a bracket. Okay. I think maybe I'm missing some brackets here. And I need to close the print. Okay, so I've closed the print. Now let me just show this everything one screen. So this is how it looks when I write it. And here I'll put a keyword sorting in descending order. So let's check the output. So it should give me values from 12 to so on to minus 3. Okay, do you see that? Yes, so now we are able to sort the list in descending order. And why it was able to sort it in descending order? Because we gave a key argument to it, and instead of writing a method and providing the method name here, we relied on lambda. So lambdas are some kind of, we can relate them to some kind of functions which do not have any name. So I can explain what happens everything. For each and every element of sample numbers, the lambda is called, where each element of list takes the takes place of that var. So the one goes to, then the max of sample is 12 minus 1, that ensures what is the difference given, that ensures that the list is sorted in descending order. So wherever we need to pass a quick methods where it's not much important to rely on name, but we just need a small workaround trick, we usually rely on lambda. But a true uses of lambda is where we it's needed a scenario where developers are more interested in writing a function wrappers, and also using methods like map, reduce and filter. And we'll be looking that into some other video. So this is it for this video here, as far as this hands-on session is considered. So I would like to try one thing. So for example, what would happen here, inc by 2, for example, I have lambda here. What would happen if I provide multiple expressions? So can I have a multiple expression? For example, if I say, okay, let us, before going for multiple expressions, let us do one thing. Can I have multiple variables? And it was like, okay, var plus What do you think? Will it change the output here? So if I execute this code now, so lambda takes exactly two arguments, but given one. So now you, it's like a normal method call, wherein if you have a method with two arguments, you have to provide both arguments unless you define the other argument as a default argument or multiple arguments. But this is a good indication that, okay, lambdas are exactly, they work like a methods. So now what you need to do is you need to provide two parameters. Fine. So I'm providing a third parameter on argument. So now if I execute, you should see that it's working fine. But remember, I had only used one expression. What do you think? Can I use multiple expressions here? For example, if I say var 2 plus 1, is it possible here? So if you run this, what you'll see that you'll find an error where var 2 is not defined. So what's effectively it is telling us, the lambda expression shall not contain more than one expression. And if any need arises for such multiple calculation, instead of this one, for example, okay, we can do this. We can do this, var 2 less 2. It's a quick workaround. See, remember, these are two operations, but what I'm doing is I'm actually returning two. Let me check this. I don't think it, yes. Okay, now you can see that function call. And here I have a lambda call. Remember, it's a one single expression. You might think we have multiple expressions, that no. Overall, this it's an expression of expressions, but overall it's a one single expressions. Into this video, I would like to put a question like, does a lambda allow multiple expressions? You can pause the video. You can watch the video from the beginning and you can guess the answer. But the right answer for this question is no. Lambda does not allow multiple expressions in it. As a part of this video, I refer the following links, which acts as a bibliography of this video. And that's it for this video. Thank you.